in the central Kalahari in Botswana. The Kalahari is sometimes called the Thirsty Land. It's the world's oldest desert, and in some places, the sand is a mile deep. The Kalahari is one of those places where some of the most interesting animals are going to be. But the place is very dry. It gets water in two ways. One way is by rainfall. And this is the rainy season. So what you're going to see is about as green as it gets here. There is another way. And that is the rains that occur at this time of year also occur in Namibia. And the water from Namibia flows down from the highlands and it ends up in a river called the Okavango. And the Okavango breaks into a delta, and that delta spreads out in northern Botswana. And there the sands drink it. It wasn't always that way. The land over millions of years rose. A million years ago, the Okavango would have continued beyond the delta and gone down to a lake, the largest lake in Africa at that time. Now, that lake is the Mgadigadi Pan. It is a dry salt pan, and it only has water in it at seasonal times, and very shallow water at that. Between the salt pans and the delta, there's a small river valley, the Boteti. The Boteti River, for decades, had no water in it. But recently, it has been flowing again.
The itinerary that I worked up said we're going in the summer. The temperature is going to be about 100 degrees, and it was. Every day. But it was supposed to be rainy. This is the rainy season. But in fact, there hasn't been any significant rain since last April. And things are in desperate condition because last year it was unusually dry as well. Now this dryness probably occurred because of the El Nino that's going on. Several times I got caught in dust storms like this one. Pretty horrific storms, actually. And even in the best of times, the Kalahari doesn't have much surface water. That's because of all that sand that's out there. What water does come quickly drops below the surface of the ground. However, they do have aquifers. And what people and the animals are depending on is that in the pans where there's clay, the government has put in pumps and has pumped up water into those pans so that the animals have something to drink. But even so, this is extremely dry. Now, one of the benefits of going in the dry season, or any dry season, is that the animals will be concentrated at the water holes. But from the animal's standpoint, this is a real problem, because where the water is and where the food is are two different places, and they often have to walk tens of miles to go from one to the other.
Rain is so important in this area that the currency is called the pula. Pula means rain.
The major exception to the lack of surface water is the Boteti River. For decades, it didn't flow at all, and then it started flowing about 10 years ago or so. It's not really flowing now. It's merely an intermittent stream, a sort of a long lake, if you will, or series of lakes, and it's not very deep. It's only a few inches deep in most places. I have selected a lodge above the Boteti River on a cliff, and so Animal Planet is continuously showing down below. The name of the campsite, and it is a tent campsite, is the Tooth of the Crocodile. But ever since the Boteti went dry a few decades ago, there haven't really been any large crocodiles. There may be some small ones down there. But when the Boteti dried up, it took all the crocodiles with it. Nevertheless, the zebra often act as though they're concerned that there are crocodiles in this water. They must remember it or have seen crocodiles someplace. Now, one thing you might notice is that the noise that a zebra makes is not much like the noise that a horse makes. It's a lot more like the noise that a donkey makes. It would seem that while they're drinking there, somebody thinks that he saw a crocodile. And everybody takes off and heads up the hill, or almost everybody anyway, anybody with any sense, because they're herd animals, and when the herd moves, so does everyone else. But it doesn't take them very long to decide there really isn't any danger. And the zebra are quite thirsty. They've had to walk tens of miles to get in from where they usually do their grazing in order to get to this river. This is the only major source of water in the entire Kalahari area. Zebra are one of those animals that need large amounts of water, and so they and the elephants are almost always here at the river. Now, when the crocodiles discovered that the Boteti had dried up some decades ago, they didn't immediately go away. Instead, they went into holes in the side of the cliff walls. Now, the crocodiles didn't dig those holes themselves, but they did take them over from other animals like aardvarks and so forth, which dig this sort of thing. In any event, the crocodiles had some trouble killing prey. They were actually killing them on dry land and trying to eat them, but crocodiles aren't good at that. And so eventually all the big crocodiles died out. Nowadays, the zebra are primarily harassed by the other big animal that needs lots of water, the elephants. The elephants don't allow the zebra to drink near them if they can avoid it. They tend to be the bullies of the river. Like the zebra, the elephants have to drink a great deal of water, and their food is also miles and miles away from here, their major sources of food. And so when they come in from browsing, they come in very rapidly. They are very excited to be near large quantities of relatively clean, fresh water. For them, this is a real treat. They need to take a drink and a bath. These elephants are all bulls. The reason for that is because the cows and the calves have a hard time making a living out on the Kalahari. It's really just too tough for them. But the bulls can make it out here. The African elephant, at the end of its trunk, has two lips or fingers that allow it to pick up very small things. The Indian elephant only has one of those. And the African elephant has tusks with both the male and the female. And those tusks are very important tools for getting water and food. The African elephant can weigh up to around 13,000 pounds, and live for about 60 years. It lives for 60 years because at 50 years, their teeth start to wear out. They eat about 300 pounds of food a day, and that's why those teeth wear out so quickly. The water holes are good for drinking, of course, but also for bathing. Elephants really love to take mud baths. It cools them down and it protects the skin. Once the mud has dried, it protects the skin against both the sun and insects. This water hole would be dry at this time of year and under these circumstances, except for the fact that water is being continuously pumped up by people from the aquifers. And of course, nobody would be doing that if it weren't for the tourist industry. Now this water is very precious to the elephants, and they don't intend to share it. Well, amongst themselves, yes, they will, but they don't want to share it with other animals, especially not zebras. They will block the zebras from getting to the water hole, and of course the zebras need the water every bit as much as the elephants do. This water, though, is not entirely satisfactory to the elephants, at least not for drinking purposes. And the result is that they will frequently come to the lodges and they will try to drink from the swimming pools. Now, when the elephants drink from the swimming pools, they suck the water up in their trunks. And then they taste the chlorine. Elephants hate chlorine. And so they tend to spit it out. And then they go back for more water from the swimming pool and spit it out. Well, the problem, of course, is that they drain the swimming pool pretty quickly. And they don't get a whole lot out of it. And so they start looking for the water tanks. And they will really tear up the water tanks at the lodges if they're given the opportunity to. And so the lodges have to take action in order to keep the elephants at bay, and that's especially true at night. At night, if the elephants are threatening their water supply, the lodges typically will set a fire and burn hot chili peppers in the fire. The hot chili peppers get into the elephants' trunks and drive them away. One night, this particular elephant was right next to my tent, and we had to get some folks to drive it away from there. But it had been